friends, welcome back to my channel, and today I have my June wrap-up. I read a bit this month. I don't feel like I had a great reading month, but now looking at, like, the numbers, it's not too bad. I just think I had, like, a good couple of weeks, and then the last 2 weeks were pretty slumpy, so, yeah. So there's that. But let me just kind of run through everything I read this week, and then I think I'm just gonna, like, list off kind of the books I think I'm gonna be reading in July. I don't feel like, I have enough for, like, an entire July TBR video, and I also don't feel like I've been following my TBR, at all. Like, I think I've read, like, 2 books off of my June TBR, because, yeah, I'm just really bad at, sticking to plan, apparently. So, yeah, without further ado, the first book I read this month was All Boys Aren't Blue by George M. Johnson. I listened to this on audiobook, and it's narrated by, George M. Johnson himself, which this is, like, a new category of books that I just, like, am obsessed with. I'm obsessed with memoirs that are narrated by their own authors, because I just feel like it adds, like, an extra layer of, like, emotional depth that, like, you don't quite get when you just read the book. I feel personally, I don't know, I loved this audiobook. This was amazing. I sobbed. I have no words. It's basically, like, a collection of personal essays that Johnson wrote, and they go through, like, different parts of their lives, discovering their identity, etc., etc. What I loved most about this book was how Johnson portrayed, even though Johnson's been through so much, they portray everything with, like, a hopeful tone, like, hopeful for the future, and, like, it's very inspirational, it's very moving. I highly, highly recommend it for everyone, really. I mean, obviously, I know nothing about being Black or being queer, really, or being non-binary or anything like that, but I think it's such a great insight into, like, what it's like for Johnson, and I don't know, I really, really liked it. I don't want to spoil it, but there's one chapter in particular where he talks about his, like, fraternity, and the brotherhood he found there. Oh, it's so, it's so good, it's so moving. I highly, highly recommend it. It was such a great start to the month as well, so yeah, highly, highly recommend. Then after that, I picked up The Fifth Season by N.K. Jemisin, which has been on my TBR for quite some time now. I was recommended this, actually, like, by a real life friend a while ago. Never picked it up because the second person perspective was a little intimidating to me, and to be honest, still is not my favorite thing, but I really love this. If you saw my review, I gave this 5 stars on Goodreads. Oh, sorry, I also gave All Boys Aren't Blue 5 stars. So I started the month with 2 5-star reads, which I was very, very happy about. If you're interested, I do have a full spoiler-free review of this on my channel. So yeah, I fully annotated this. It was such a great experience. Reading this and annotating it. I really, really love this. Shortly after that, I ended up starting The Obelisk Gate. I still haven't finished it. I'm only about just under halfway through. I was supposed to buddy read this with Sophia from Fantasy Book Addict, but I feel like neither of us have actually finished it, so I actually have to check in with her. Sorry, Sophia. Love you. But yeah, so I will be reading this in July as well. And then after that, I wanted, like, a one-day quick read, so I ended up picking up The Black Tides of Heaven by J.Y. Yang, which was on my June TBR. This is a fantasy novella set in an kind of, like, Asian-inspired world. I gave this book a 3 stars, and I don't mean that in a bad way. I actually thought this had a lot of potential. I just felt like I felt like Yang tried to do a lot in a very short number of pages, because it is a novella. So this is part of a series of novellas. There's currently 4 novellas out, so I am interested in picking up more of the novellas, or the next one, rather, and continuing on in the series, just to kind of see where it goes, because I don't know if my issues with the first one will ever be solved, because my issue is that there's a lot of, like, huge time skips, so, like, you miss out on a lot of the stories, part of me is just like, I just want this story. But I really love the world. The world is really, really interesting. I love the way that Yang, as a non-binary author, weaves in non-binary identity into the novel. So in this book, people are born non-binary. People aren't ascribed gender, and they have to, like, choose their own gender. And then also sexuality as well is very, very fluid in this novel. And it's just handled in a very, like, I don't know. I really loved it. I really loved it. I really loved the world. The magic system seemed really cool, but that's another thing that I felt like I didn't fully understand the magic system because it wasn't really explained or shown to me in the short number of pages. My rating is because I liked everything, but I felt like everything needed a bit more. So that's why I only give it a 3 stars. It's still not a, like, for me, 3 stars is not a bad rating. I still think that's a solid book. And I think it's a good book. I just didn't love it. So that was that. The next book I read, because I just wanted, like, a bit of a palate cleanser, so I went for, like, a one-day romance. And I read The Wedding Party by Jasmine Guillory. Is that how you pronounce her name? I hope so. I also gave this 3 stars. It's really difficult for me to give a romance more than 3 stars, in all honesty. It is so tropey. It is so, like, standard. And that's how I feel about most romances. Again, it's not a bad thing. I don't feel like it was, like, outstanding enough to warrant a 4 or... I've never given a romance a 5 stars, so that's pretty much, like, off the table at this point. But I just didn't feel like it was next level enough to give it a 4 stars. But I thought this was a solid romance. I actually didn't realize when I borrowed this from the library that it's the 3rd in a book, in a series, but I also don't think it matters because it's, like, about each book is about a different couple, so I didn't feel like I was missing anything. This is a kind of, like, enemies to friends with benefits to lovers kind of situation. I thought it was a very, very solid romance. I really enjoyed it. I think it's a great, like, summer beachy kind of read. I did feel like at the 75% mark, I just was like, just talk to each other, honestly, like, just speak. I get really annoyed. But to be honest, I feel like most romances are like that. I'm like, if you just, like, actually spoke to each other, we wouldn't have a book. So, but I did feel like it dragged on a little bit, and that's why, for me, I feel like it wasn't quite 4 stars, it was 3 stars. I will likely, if my library has them available, end up picking up at least the first book in the series, I think. Because I think each book has, like, a different, like, romance trope. And the first one is fake dating, which I love. At the second one, I don't remember what the trope is, but I remember reading the synopsis. And I was kind of like, not as interested in this love story. Meh. This one, obviously, enemies to lovers is, we all know, I love. So, and then after that, I binge read all 3 volumes of Fence. I love this so much. I read this because Ella from Ella's Novellas recommended it, and she talked about it in a few of her videos. She compared it to Haikyuu, which is pretty much, like, sold. I'm sold. So I read it. I loved it. The 4th volume just came out yesterday, so I am really excited to get to that soon. Hopefully my library will get it. I got the first 3 volumes through my library. I gave Fence all 3 volumes 4 stars. I thought it was really, really good. I don't feel like it was, like, a 5 stars per se, but I loved it. I thought it was fantastic. Next, I read White Rage for the Blackout Buddy read. I gave this a 4 stars tentatively. Like, I don't fully know how to rate nonfiction yet, so I might, like, revisit my ratings for nonfiction once I actually, like, figure out how I feel, like, how I want to rate them. But for now, I gave it a 4 stars. I thought it was very, very dense. This was definitely a dense read, especially the first, like, 2 or 3 chapters that were a little bit more history heavy, because I went into it pretty much knowing, like, 0 American history. I didn't take American history in school, so therefore learned very little American history in school. In case you are new here, I'm not American. I am Canadian. So yeah, we learned maybe, like, a tiny bit of American history, but to be on in, like, early years. But yeah, in high school, basically in grade 10, you take a class called Canadian history, And that's your only, like, mandatory history class in high school. So we don't actually have American history in our curriculum, unless you opt to take it, which I didn't. So a lot of that information was new to me. I was, like, curious as to, like, how much of that was overlapped with, like, actual, like, American high school education. I was very curious about that. So if you are American and you read White Rage, let me know down below how much of that was new information to you, how much of that you actually learned in high school, because I find that really interesting. But overall, I thought this was a really important read. I really liked the later chapters where they go into racial zoning, the war on drugs, the civil rights movement, and, like, voter suppression, and I really liked how Anderson was able to kind of tie in all the history and show how all these, like, current issues are rooted in history, and I really, really liked that aspect of it. Again, it was a very dry read, and a dense read, so I probably will have to revisit this at some point in the future, maybe next year, give it a year to kind of, like, settle in and read other things and then come back to it, so... But either way, I think it's a really great place to start, and I'm glad that Shay chose this for the Blackout Buddy read. The second book in the Blackout Buddy read, White Fragility. I DNF'd this at 50%, approximately 50%. I realize that I might not exactly be the target audience for this, per se. I feel like I'm kind of, like, halfway, because I am obviously not white, but I'm also white adjacent in a lot of spaces. So I don't know. I was really hoping to get something new from it, but I just, in the first half of the book, was not getting any sort of new information beyond what I learned in high school. It was very, like, white privilege 101. That's what it felt like. Not even 101, like, pre-101. And I would just rather spend that time reading something else that I could actually, like, learn something new from. So I did DNF it. I might come back to it. If you've read the whole thing and you feel like there's something useful in the second half of the book, do let me know. For me, I wasn't learning anything new. I really wanted the author to maybe delve into certain things that, like, I myself, as a white adjacent person, haven't, like, realized or haven't seen, but so far I wasn't getting that. I was just getting a lot of stuff that I already knew, either from learning about it in the past or from experiencing it myself as a non-white person. So, again, I totally realize that I may not be the target audience for this book. It is very much a book written by a white author for white people. That's kind of how I felt about it. So I didn't feel bad about DNFing this one, but I didn't rate it. I don't believe in rating books that you have not finished all the way through. I believe in writing, you can write a review for it, and I absolutely did, but I just didn't rate it because I don't think that's fair. That's my opinion. I don't know. Anyway, the next book I read was You Should See Me in a Crown by Leah Johnson. I listened to this on audiobook, and it was narrated by Alaska Jackson. It was fantastic. If you watched my reading vlog from last week, you kind of have seen my, like, initial thoughts about it. I absolutely love this book. I gave this 4 out of 5 stars. It wasn't quite perfect, but I thought it was very, very, very good, very cute. If you're looking for, like, a heartwarming, sweet romance, but also touches on some, like, tougher topics, I think this is a really great one. If you don't know what it is, Liz is our main character. She finds out that she has not gotten the scholarship that she really wanted for school, and so she decides to run for prom queen because you get, like, money for school through that program, I guess, whatever, and she ends up falling for her competition, and it's very super sweet. It's so cute. I need it to be, like, a Netflix, like, movie now. Like, now. Netflix, if you're watching. Hey. But yeah, so I really love that. And then the last book I read this month that I just finished 2 days ago was Jade City by Fonda Lee. I gave this 4 out of 5 stars, probably closer to a 4.5 stars if I'm going to be honest. I still haven't fully processed all my emotions and my thoughts. I'm a bit of an empty shell of a human being right now. I am going to be doing a full review on this, spoiler-free end with spoiler at the end, because I have a lot of spoilery thoughts about this book. I might pick up Jade War this month. I don't think I have, like, the space for it, to be completely honest, just given what I have to read and also starting a new job and everything. So I don't think I'll have time for it this month, but I do want to get to it maybe in August. But I don't know. Katie from Brightness Katie Reed said that it is the ending of Jade War is the most traumatizing thing she's ever read, so I'm scared. But if you don't know what Jade City is about, it's basically set in an alternate, I see it as like Hong Kong, like an alternate Hong Kong, and you have kind of two kind of opposing gangs, and they are competing for power. And then the magic system uses Jade in this world, and yeah, there's a lot of like family drama. I thought this was amazing. I will explain in my full review why I didn't quite feel like it was a 5 stars for me, but I would highly recommend this to anybody. I think it's a great read. I think it's a very easy read as well. There's a lot of action scenes, so if you're into action, I think you'd like this a lot. So that is my wrap-up for June. I read 3 graphic novels and 7 books, so not too bad. Yeah, not the worst. Oh, forgot about manga. I haven't read too much manga this month, actually. I read the equivalent of like the first 2 or 3 volumes of Claymore. I didn't end up reading Vampire Knight, honestly, because I started it and the font is, I forgot how annoying the font is and how ugly it is. And I can't handle it, so I stopped reading that because of that. I read a few more chapters of Bleach, and I started The Promised Neverland, but never got too far into it. But I am hoping to be reading more manga this month as well. As for July, what I need to read, obviously, I need to finish The Obelisk Gate. I also just started yesterday Nevermore, The Trials of Morgan Crow. I'm about a third of the way in, I guess. I'm loving this so far, so I'm going to be finishing this in the next few days. I need to finish The Black Flamingo by Dean Atta, which I'll probably finish today as well. And then what else? I need to finish The Skinwalker. Basically, I have a lot of stuff that I need to finish that I didn't finish from this month. I have to finish The Skinwalker by Desmond Cole. And then also, I'll probably be picking one more book from my nonfiction TBR as well. I have to read Monstrous, A Long Way to a Small and Angry Planet by Becky Chambers, and House on the Cerulean Sea by T.J. Klune for a video, I guess, that I'm doing. And then I have so many books I want to read, honestly. So those are kind of the main books that I like need to read. I also want to get to The Silence of Bones by June Herr. I started it, but I was feeling something a little more lighthearted, which is why I ended up picking up Nevermore instead. Of the one chapter I read, I was like absolutely hooked, so I do want to read that this month. Hopefully, maybe, we'll see. And then also, I have been wanting to start The Count of Monte Cristo for ages, and Ashley at Bookish Realm is coincidentally starting her buddy read of this. So I think the first, for July, we have to read like 200-ish pages, which I'm not 100% sure if I can do, but I will try and I will hopefully keep up with that buddy read. But I'm really excited to hopefully dive into this month. What else? I think that's pretty much it. I want to keep reading Bleach. I'm at about the 450 chapter mark. And there's about 600 and something chapters. So I want to get to like the 500 chapter mark. For that. And I think that's pretty much it for now. I think I have my hands full already with that, but as you know, I'm a mood reader. It's why I'm not doing it like a formal TBR anymore. So yeah, if you have any like book recommendations, books you think I should get to, soon, leave them down below. And I will try to get to them. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and comment down below if you've read any of the books I read this month and what you plan on reading for July as well. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time.